In today's video, we are gonna learn about center method and assignment operators. So, what is the purpose of this center method and why we use it in our programming? So, by using this method, we can add left and right equally in our string. So, let's consider an example. If I write name, so if I want to write something, it's left and right side, so I can use this method. Here you can see the length of this name is 5. It includes 5 alphabets. So if I extend this length by 7, so there are 2 extra, because I want to add something, it's right side and in left side. So if I want to add a star is Tariq here, so if I run it, you can see the star is added in left side and right side. So what if I write here, instead of 7 I write 6? So if I run it, you can see the right side, the only star is added. So we can add anything instead of a star. If I suppose I write here 9 and I want to add some gap instead of a Tariq, so you will see that the gap is added equally in right side and in left side. So if I run it, you can see there is some extra gap we can add. So by using center method, we can add anything in our string equally in left side and right side or unequally. So let's moving towards assignment operators. What are assignment operators? You can see here, if I write a string here, and we have learned that we cannot multiply a string to an integer value, but if we multiply it a variable to suppose 4, so you will see my name will print 4 times here. You will see, you can see my name is printed 4 times. So what if I write a name here and I create it, and if I again want to learn it and I create a variable called last name is equals to, so we can add it by name pillars is equals to. You can see here I use a plus operator here, but its syntax is different. So this is different syntax called assignment operator. So we can same do it by multiplication, division and minus. So I print name here in the next line, because if I print it same line, it will generate an error. So if I run it, you can see these two strings are merged together. So for some gap, I have to put some gap in my last name is in starting. So if I run it, you can see the gap, now it is perfect. So the same thing we can do in multiplication. So I create the same example, there's some different name called Rohit. Okay, I can generate it by name multiply by n is equals to suppose 6. So we have learned that if it is multiplied by 6, this name will be printed 6 times here. So I put some gap in the last, so there will show some gap. Print name. You can see here this name is printed 6 times, but this time its syntax is a little bit different. So I have to, if I write my name but I forget to put IR in Umair, so how can I put IR? I can use the same syntax here, plus is equals to, and I can add the direct string. In previous we are adding variables, but we can add the direct string in our variable. So if I run it, if I print it, different name. So you can see here my name. These two strings, variable and string, will concatenate together. So it is all about today. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel and share this video. Thank you very much.